Welcome to Wise Beyond Bitcoin, where you come for the crypto neo news, education, opportunities, and macro updates. My name is Lucas.
My name is Ryan.
And we've got some major innovation opportunities in this video because we're talking about a project, a protocol that is developing a major, major value in the blockchain ecosystem, but they're actually not out yet. So you have plenty of time to do your own research and to figure out where you can be with your MetaMask wallet or Kepler wallet to be ready to support this new blockchain community. And it's developed in a blockchain community that we like to cover a lot when it comes to interoperability, and that's the IBC. But Axelar is reaching beyond the IBC. They're doing some really big things. So let's talk about what Axelar, the value that they're adding to the future of blockchain and crypto. We're looking at this bear market, this consolidation time. And as you know, this is when a lot of the activity, when a lot of the real value in building takes place. We've been through ICOs. We've seen the advent of AMM DEXs and liquidity being provided, you know, from all around the world and different blockchains mimicking and showing how this can be developed, whether on Avalanche or on Ethereum or Polygon. We've seen scalability issues come up you know, a lot of innovation for it to take place. It has to take place after you can look back and see some of the pitfalls, the failures, or the problems from what was built earlier. And we're kind of at that phase now. And I think what the Axelar network with the developers, the team are building over there, this is one of the biggest value added features to the next level of blockchain and crypto, really.
Yeah, I would agree. I mean, when you look across crypto and blockchain, what's unfinished? What problems remain? There's many, but the big ones are the fragmentation of the different blockchains and how, you know, it's difficult to sometimes move assets from one to the other, and the bridges that do exist often are vulnerable. They are hacked. Beyond that, there are issues with the user experience. You know, some wallets, some exchanges, the API, is not always as clean as it could be. And often it's, the knowledge that you need to have in order to make use of these tools is more than it should be. And it's kind of off-putting to people who are, you know, just maybe trying to get into it for the first time. So a better user experience and then composability across these chains to where you can interact and do cross-chain maneuvers that's lacking. Now, I, of course, Cosmos, Tendermint, IBC, that ecosystem with its interoperability at the forefront, you know, they are also solving this problem. But even with that, the interoperability is within those Cosmos chains, within the IBC, right? And of course, we're seeing that chain, we're seeing Evmos and Gravity and other projects building bridges to the EVM Ethereum world. But even all that's, it's still within its infancy, right? And Axelar is doing the same idea, but they're going one step beyond. They're looking to be chain agnostic. So not just bridging Ethereum and Cosmos together, but they're looking to even include Bitcoin and, you know, and chains that are not smart contracts even, right? That are not part of the smart contract, Web3 world. So Bitcoin is an obvious one. So they're really doing some cool stuff, and the idea is to create a home where developers can build protocols that enable people to move assets across chain, to communicate across chain, and to do all this within a single wallet, a single software protocol. And yeah, so we're looking at revolutionary stuff here.
Big time. And like you mentioned, this is the IBC. We'll leave this link, map of zones, all the educational links below so you can do your own research. But this is just the IBC. As you mentioned, Axelar is looking to build this communication, these APIs to bring communities together, not just in the IBC, but we'll also have this Axelar scan, which shows other major blockchains in the ecosystem that are outside the IBC that are on the EVM, the Ethereum side, you know, and like in the future, even Bitcoin, its own blockchain. But the point is Polygon, Ethereum, Injective, Moonbeam, Osmosis, IBC, we've got Crescent, Atom. We've got an article that recent collaboration with Secret Network because of its privacy feature, which we love to share, have more updates with the developments going on there as well. But this is this Ophantom network and Avalanche, you know, and it's still growing. But these are the cross-chain transfers that are enabled through Axelar network. This is very, very, very exciting. I mean, this is absolutely innovation, early stage innovation for blockchain and crypto. And again, we're a macro-minded channel. Our views, we like to look for protocols, projects that are going to add value, revolutionize the economy, bring something efficient to the market, make some great change. And this is, again, when you follow crypto and blockchain, what are those projects? Are they just repeating something? Are they adding something new? Are they making crypto blockchain more secure, more scalable, more decentralized? What's actually being brought?
Easier to use.
And here, Axelar is bridging, making it easier to use and bridging all of these ecosystems. Right now, you may have developers on Ethereum that are really good developing on Ethereum, or really good working with Polygon, or really used to Osmosis or Moonbeam. And this will allow people who are maybe familiar with one of these protocols or none of them to build an application, a website that they can tap in through the API. They can tap into the information on all of these different relevant chains. You know, like we mentioned.
Well, one usage, right, we should talk about would be you could create an airdrop that would be cross-chain, right? You could have a website, you could advertise whatever it is your product was, and then you can reward people who interacted with your website, and it wouldn't matter if they were coming from Polygon or from Ethereum or from Bitcoin or from the Cosmos IBC, you could have a reward that would apply, that would be available for everyone, and you would do all this within a single API, a single contract that would interact with all of these other blockchains. And that's the kind of thing, that's the kind of cross-chain composability that they're trying to accomplish.
Plug and play integration. I'm just reading the bold here, and you can read the bold and the not so bold when you do your own research. This is the website, their main website. We'll also leave a link to the white paper. But as you were saying, look, what is Axelar Web3, what Stripe is for mobile internet applications? So when on your phone or on the internet, when someone wants to pay for something, anyone can build a website and then they can use Stripe. They can use Stripe so they can access their Visa, MasterCard payments. But anyone can build a website and access Stripe. And that's the same thing, Axelar. Anyone can build an application and they will be able to tap in through Axelar to Ethereum, to Polygon, to these different networks, whether it's for an airdrop or sending information. And I don't know if you mentioned this already, but they're actually looking at going beyond just communicating between the networks. They're actually creating an interface to allow people to actually exchange from just, because as of right now, you don't know, and you're new to crypto, if you want to be involved in Ethereum, you have your Ethereum wallet through MetaMask, usually, if you're using it on the internet. If you want to get involved with IBC, you've got your Kepler wallet. Now, at the moment, if you're wanting to send Osmosis or send Secret or send Ethereum or send Polygon, you have to do all of your work through a wallet on that specific chain. And what they're looking to create is a mechanism that allows you to use one wallet that you can send different assets using the Axelar network, so that you don't have to go from wallet to wallet and chain to chain.
Right, exactly. We're gonna list, we'll have the white paper, we'll link it below. And it goes through some of the ins and outs, the details of how they achieve this cross-chain composability. They have a cross-chain gateway protocol, a transfer protocol. There are, and it goes into the details exactly what builders can do to utilize these protocols and to create APIs that allow various blockchains to all be composable within the same wallet or the same contract or the same software protocol. And the white paper is really, it's in depth, it's well written, and we will definitely have a link below so you can read and see more if you're a developer, if this is something that you want to work in or not. But definitely the idea here would be trying to make these separate fragmented silos bring them all under one roof, under one protocol, right? Where they can, where blockchains can interact with one, basically all within a similar, within one environment, without having to go from Uniswap to Osmosis, you know, swap it to go bridges and go to exchanges, and it just to have it, make it real simple, all in one easy to use API that is plugged into all these different chains.
That's it.
That's the idea.
The following advantage for blockchain platform builders: ability to easily plug in their blockchains to all other blockchain ecosystems. Only a threshold account needs to be set up on the Axelar chain to plug into the network. For dApps, decentralized application builders can host their dApps anywhere, lock, unlock, transfer assets, NFTs, and communicate with applications on any other chain via their cross-chain protocol, CTP API. For users can interact with all applications across the ecosystem directly from their wallets. And so it's really just about streamlining it, making it easier.
Right.
You know, in the beginning of the internet days, any early developers, I'm sure, could send an email if they knew the code and knew the language. Like, there was a way that you could send a message if you knew how to type /. I don't know the language that well. That's not my forte. But before, they made it easy. Like right now, all of us can send an email just by clicking send. You know, you don't need the code. You used to have to write the code out in order to do it. Now you just hit the send button. So they're really going to streamline and make it easy for people to to interact with other blockchains. This is very exciting. And all of it is here in the white paper. So make sure you get
it. Do we want to maybe mention the secret partnership with Axelar and what they're doing? Because that's pretty cool.
They've got a few partnerships as well. They're obviously going to be building a lot of partnerships because they are, I mean, this is good if you're on Secret or if you're on Polygon, because you don't want your communities or your builders to be siloed only to that network. And right. by creating a connection between these different blockchains, they're adding value. They're opening the floodgates for more users to interact. So,
right.
They are definitely.
It also brings liquidity across chain now.
It's true.
To support, you know, the community instead of it being, like you said, siloed.
In fact, Trisolaris Labs partners with Axelar, and they're going to use the SQUID liquidity routing module that enables cross-chain swaps. So, yeah, we can see that the liquidity from different blockchains coming together that will increase liquidity and make it easier for cross-chain swaps. But let's go back to that partnership you just mentioned, because Secret Network is a big deal when it comes to privacy. And that obviously has been in the news lately, but privacy is not something that is guaranteed. It's not something that comes with crypto or blockchain. It's not inherent. In fact, it's the opposite. When you come to the security of Bitcoin or Ethereum or blockchain in general, what makes it so secure is that anyone anywhere in the world can verify on chain publicly. And that creates a problem when you're building applications to send finances, to send money, to send messages that you don't want other people to see, or NFTs that are tickets that you don't want other people to see what maybe that NFT represents or stands for. So there's a realm in the world, in the universe, for human beings
all have privacy.
All companies today, every bank, every company, every school, they keep the records private. You have to have permission in order to get the records. Are these your records? You know, is this your bank account? And so it's, you know, as great as blockchain and crypto is, one of the pink elephants in the room that we talk about a lot and why we continue to talk about the added value of Secret Network and what they're building is privacy. Privacy does not exist among the other great advents in blockchain and crypto. So to find a way to have that security, that decentralization, that scalability, and privacy in blockchain is a big deal. And so what's going on with Axelar Network integrating with Secret Network?
Right. Well, they have a partnership, and Secret is going to be the privacy solution for Axelar, and they're going to enable Secret's going to be the privacy messaging service, so that people can send messages. They could send private NFTs, private NFT trading. It solves the front. We always talk about the swaps and AMMs and the problem with front running and miner extracted value. So there's another use case for privacy as well. And they're basically, the idea is that privacy on Secret is going to help Axelar and achieve the privacy. Oh man, I lost my train of thought.
No, you're
privacy.
Well, the front running is a big deal. And we talked about that on Secret Network. And it's cool that, well, what's Axelar doing? It's allowing people to send between Polygon, Ethereum, Avalanche, IBC projects. That's great, but we're going to run into that same problem with miner extracted value and front running.
Yes.
In Secret Network, we've known for quite some time, if you've been following this channel or others that talk about Secret Network and privacy, they have solved the miner extracted value front running issue by allowing that privacy to exist where people don't have access to that information.
Right.
In the swaps. So Axelar is saying, okay, well, that's great that you have achieved that miner extracted value front running for Secret Network, but we've got a slight dilemma because we're putting together these other public blockchains that don't have that privacy.
Right.
And Secret Network says, don't worry about that. You route those swaps through us and we will make it private. And so this is kind of the future. This will be the future. I could see the future of exchanges in crypto blockchain using this technology. It doesn't make sense, to have miner extracted value, to have front running. It doesn't make sense.
Right.
We're trying to remove intermediaries. In fact, isn't this one of the biggest problems from the traditional financial markets that we're hoping that
very much
can solve? In traditional financial markets, we have to have intermediaries that make sure that these trades go through, that have liquidity that can affect a lot of the changes in the market. And when you move to blockchain, that those intermediaries are the front runners. Those are the ones that's their service they get paid for. It's like, well, if we're going to make sure your exchanges go through and we're holding all this liquidity, we're going to have to make our piece of the pie too. And they do.
Right.
The way the system works is there's a lot of value extracted.
But there's a limit to what maybe they need to be able to have access to, right? Because the payment, the gas fee that they get, and or if it's a, if it's a, yeah, the gas fee they get for clearing for validating the transaction ought to be enough reward, but it doesn't need to be, this other back end part that you didn't improve.
Right.
That we're gonna pull out of your pocket in a sly way, without your permission. That's what's going on in mainstream finance. And it is definitely what's going on in blockchain finance as well.
Right.
And to your point, why we do want to create a digital. We are trying to recreate the world on the blockchain, but we don't want to create every little element of it, right? There are some things we don't want. And I think front running is and or miner extracted value, we don't need that. So to be able to bring this protection to other chains through Axelar and Secret and partnering together, that's awesome.
Very cool. And here, let me just move us up here. Not be in the way. Axelar cross-chain communication means that Secret, built in the Cosmos ecosystem, can now extend its privacy benefits to users and developers on EVM chains like Avalanche, Polygon, and other and Polkadot. This is huge. Look, we've been big fans of what they're building on Secret Network for the value of blockchain in general. This is just Axelar, what they're doing is going to be great at opening the floodgates for more people to see the value of Secret
Network. Makes it even better.
Makes it even better. So this is what a beautiful collaboration between Axelar and Secret Network. And of course, there will definitely be more collaborations with Axelar in their work and with Secret Network. And we will definitely keep you abreast of the latest developments and innovations there. This is really some of the most cutting innovation going on in blockchain and crypto. This is the Trisolaris article. It's another recent collaboration with Axelar. And it just goes to show the increased liquidity and the growth of DeFi. I think in order for DeFi to have legs and to grow moving forward, it needs to bring different communities, different blockchains together. And Axelar is the solution to make that happen.
Very cool. I know we have a little video we wanted to kind of follow up with or kind of wrap up our presentation of Axelar with.
We do. And the question is, do you feel that you have an understanding of what Axelar does and what it is? And if not, do you feel that this 2-minute video they made is a lot better than everything we just explained? You can watch it right now. Everything's going to be timestamped and we'll watch it with you. Let's find out.
We believe that Web3 is the future. Axelar is developing the core infrastructure and tooling necessary for developers to innovate with blockchain technology and provide their end users with amazing application experiences. We achieve this by addressing the fragmentation and painful user experiences for developers and end users in today's blockchain ecosystems. Here's how. Axelar is the universal overlay network, securely connecting all blockchain ecosystems, applications, assets, and users, enabling developers to build on the best blockchain for their particular use case. The overlay network supports asset transfer, composability of applications, and generalized message passing across any blockchain ecosystem through protocols and APIs. This means developers can build their applications on one blockchain and allow their users to interact with assets, users, and dApps on any other blockchain. So what's in this stack? At its core, Axelar is a decentralized network run by a permissionless set of validators that power cross-chain interoperability requests. Designed to achieve universal interoperability, the network is blockchain agnostic, supporting diverse approaches to consensus. With only a few lines of code, protocol developers can add arbitrary chains to the network through the permissionless validators. On top of the network sit Axelar Relay Services and the Axelar SDK. The SDK allows easy access to the network and composability across the unified network of blockchains through a collection of application layer protocols and APIs. Application developers use the SDK to efficiently connect their applications, enabling greater distribution across all chains, cross-chain composability with other apps, and greater liquidity. Here are some examples. Users can swap their ETH for Atom through a decentralized exchange directly from their wallet. Users have the convenience and ability to transact from a single universal wallet instead of needing one for every network or type of asset they want to use. NFTs purchased on one chain become portable, traveling with owners as they interact across different chains. By connecting all isolated ecosystems through a unified network and providing developers with the tools they need, Axelar enables innovation, unlocks new possibilities, and grows this global decentralized economy that will empower users no matter where they are on their journeys through Web3. Axelar powers the cross-chain future.
Well, they explained it pretty well. That's a good graphic. So maybe that summed it up for you. Hopefully our video added some information to that. Of course, we're gonna leave all links below because this is just educational information to help you in your research. None of this is commercial advice, legal advice, financial advice, marital advice, medical advice. So go seek a professional for any of those things. But if you're looking to learn more about blockchain and crypto and you'd like to get involved and participate and maybe benefit from being an early adopter, an early adapter to this new technology, and you like to figure out how to get involved, we've got videos, we've got playlists, how to get started, how to get a Web 3.0 wallet, sending, receiving, staking, NFTs, secret network, privacy, and all the beautiful applications that are being built there, which are many and many more to come. So if you like this information, if it helped you out, you enjoy this kind of stuff and macro updates too, because there's a lot going on in the traditional markets that are affecting blockchain and crypto. In fact, we just dropped a pretty good video on what the Fed's doing with its balance sheet. That's not being talked about a lot.
So check that out.
So we'll give you some hot tips, and all you have to do is hit the subscription notification bell, thumbs up, drop a little love. And until the next time, have a beautiful day. Namaste, y'all.
Thank you.